गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, साइरा वेलकम टू दिस सेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन नंबर 3, लाइफ प्रोसेसेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म पार्ट 2। वी आर फिनिश्ड रिवाइजिंग द एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन ऑफ यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स, एसेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन ऑफ मल्टीसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स एज वेल एज सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स। वी आर फिनिश्ड रिवाइजिंग। Now let us revise the next part of the lesson. Today we are going to revise sexual reproduction in human beings. Okay, let us start with the male and female reproductive organs. Already we have finished. Let us revise with that. Okay, and before that let us learn about the chromosomes. We have studied in the chapter of heredity and variation that men have XY sex chromosome and women have XX. You all know about this. So men have XY and women has got X and X chromosomes. Okay, reproductive system with specific organs developed in the body of men and women are due to these sex chromosomes, because the organs are differing in both male and female because of this sex chromosomes only. Okay, now let us start with the male reproductive system. So the male reproductive system of human consists of testes, various ducts and glands. Okay, testes are present in the scrotum outside the abdominal cavity in male. In female it is inside all the organs, reproductive organs. Okay, the ovary, oviduct, uterus, everything is inside the abdominal cavity. In male it is outside. Testes are present in the scrotum outside the abdominal cavity. And what testes contain? Numerous seminiferous tubules. Okay, then germinal epithelium present in the tubules divide by meiosis to produce sperms. Okay, so inside the testes there are sperms produced. Those sperms are sent through various tubules. I'll show you the diagram again. From the testes it is sent to various tubules, and as they are pushed forward, okay, from one duct to the next, they become mature and they are able to fertilize the ovum. So when they are released from the testes, they are immature. As they pass from one duct to another, they will become fertilized and they'll become mature and they can fertilize with the ovum. Okay, you can see. After that I'll show you the diagram. Seminal vesicles secrete their secretion in ejaculatory duct, whereas prostate and Cooper glands secrete their secretion in urogenital tract. See the diagram. You can see here. See, this is the scrotum. Okay, and this is, here is the testis. Inside this there is testis produced, and that is taken through the tubules over here. All these tubules, it comes like this and it comes to the penis. Okay, so from here again I'll show you this is the scrotum. Okay, and you can see the tube. From the tubules you can see the seminal vesicle. This is the seminal vesicle. They secrete the secretion into urogenital, this one, ejaculatory duct. Okay, the seminal vesicle secrete into the ejaculatory duct. This is the secretions. And the Cooper glands, which is the Cooper gland here, this one, small one, this Cooper glands, as well as the prostate gland, this is down below this, they secrete into the urogenital tract. This is the urogenital tract. You can see here, this is the urogenital tract. So after the secretions all with, they mix up and with the semen, the sperms comes out. Okay, the semen is formed from sperms and secretion of all these glands. The semen is ejaculated throughout the penis. All the organs of male reproductive systems are paired except the urogenital, penis and scrotum. Okay, so except these three, urogenital is one, penis and scrotum is one, all others are paired. So I've already explained in that video. You can just go through the detail. Now I explained in short. Okay, now let us come to the female. Female, all organs of female reproductive system are in the abdominal cavity. It is not outside as in the male. okay, it is in what all it contains. This is very simple: a pair of ovaries, a pair of oviduct, single uterus and a vagina. Only four main parts: pair of ovaries, pair of oviducts, single uterus and the vagina. Besides, a pair of Bartholin gland is also present. Okay, you can see the diagram over here. You can see the ovary. This both the sides are ovary, and this tube is the oviduct. Okay, and here is the vagina. No, uterus, and here is the vagina. So four parts are there. So what happens? Every month alternate. Every month one oocyte, ovum is released from alternate ovary. So once from left ovary, then comes the right ovary. It comes through the oviduct and then it goes to the uterus. Okay, you see, an opening is present in the center of it. Oocyte enter, that is in the ovary. Okay, oocyte enters the oviduct through that opening. Okay, through that opening, this oocyte is released from alternate ovary. Cilia present on the inner surface of the oviduct that pushes the oocyte towards the uterus. Okay, so that pushes the oocyte towards the uterus. So cilia present in the oviduct, hair like structure called cilia, are present in the oviduct that pushes the oocyte into the uterus. Okay, this is the female reproductive organ. Okay, now next we will see menstrual cycle. We all have learnt already about the detail. I have explained in one video fully of menstrual cycle. You can just refer to that. In this also I will revise. Female reproductive system undergoes some changes at puberty, and those changes repeat at the interval of every 28 to 30 days. These repetitive changes are called as menstrual cycle. Menstrual cycle is a natural process controlled by four hormones. So the every female after puberty, after the age of 12 to 13, they will undergo some changes in their body, and that will repeat after every 28 to 30 days. There is a cycle, and this is called as menstrual cycle, and it is a natural process. It is controlled by four hormones. We will see the hormones on it. The four hormones are follicle stimulating hormone, that is FSH, luteinizing hormone LH, estrogen and progesterone. What are the four? Follicle stimulating, luteinizing hormone, estrogen and progesterone. These are the four hormones. One of the several follicles on the ovary starts to develop along with the oocyte present in it under the effect of follicle stimulating hormone. So first, the follicle starts developing with the help of follicle stimulating hormone. So in one of the ovary, okay, the follicle will start developing in the presence with the effect of follicle stimulating hormone. Then the developing follicle secretes estrogen, which is developing, that will secrete estrogen. Endometrium means the wall of the uterus. Endometrium of the uterus starts to develop during the first cycle or degenerate during subsequent cycles under the effect of estrogen. So the follicles which are developing, they will secrete what? Estrogen. Even the endometrium will start developing with the help of estrogen. Meanwhile, developing follicle completes its development. So when the endometrium is formed, and this follicle will complete its development, after that it bursts under the effect of luteinizing hormone. I have given in points that you remember, then you can elaborate and write. It bursts under the effect of luteinizing hormone and oocyte is released. I told you in the middle of the menstrual cycle, that is in the 13th, 14th, 15th day, that time the oocyte is released. That is called as ovulation. That period is called as a ovulation period. Remaining tissue of the burst follicle forms the corpus luteum. So after the this one is burst, okay, the oocyte is really, after the follicle is completely developed, it bursts with the help of luteinizing hormone, and the remaining part of the follicles forms the corpus luteum. This corpus luteum starts to secrete progesterone. Okay, so we learnt about now four hormones have already come. Okay, follicle stimulating, luteinizing, estrogen and progesterone. So the endometrium gland secrete their secretion under the effect of progesterone. So endometrium is ready for implantation of embryo. If oocyte is not fertilized within 24 hours, so after ovulation, okay, if the oocyte is not fertilized within 24 hours, then corpus luteum becomes inactive and transforms into corpus albicans. Okay, this is the figure. You can see this, the diagram. You can see how this is the follicle. Okay, you can see with they will be fully grown, and they will start fully grown follicle. It will be fully grown like this. They will produce estrogen and they will release ovulate during the ovulation. I told you this period. This is the 13, 14, 15th day of the cycle. There will be ovulation taking place, and the remaining of that will form corpus, corpus luteum. If it is not fertilized, then it will form corpus albicans. Okay, and this one will produce a progesterone and estrogen. This is the full menstrual cycle. Only the above process you have to learn in this. Okay, now next let us continue. Due to the secretion of estrogen and progesterone completely stops. So endometrium starts to degenerate in absence of these hormones. So this estrogen and progesterone, once they are formed, the follicle is burst and they form corpus luteum, and this estrogen and progesterone secretion is stopped, and this endometrium starts to degenerate in the absence of these two hormones. And tissues of degenerating endometrium and unfertilized ovum are discarded out through vagina, that is your menstrual cycle. So this is accompanied with continuous bleeding. Bleeding continues approximately for 5 days. This is called as menstruation. Okay, I made the important points. This one, if you learn, you can write this full answer without any mistake. First, with the effect of follicle stimulating hormone, one follicle from the ovary starts to develop. I told you, one from left ovary, next one from right ovary, one, so alternate ovaries. So with the effect of FSH, one follicle from the ovary starts to develop. Then the developing follicle releases which hormone? First, estrogen. Then endometrium starts to develop under the effect of estrogen. By the effect of luteinizing hormone, the follicle burst and oocyte is released. So what all hormones we learned? Follicle stimulating hormone, the follicle starts to develop. Then follicle release estrogen. Then endometrium starts to develop with the effect of estrogen. By the effect of luteinizing hormone, the follicle bursts and oocyte is released. Then remaining of the follicle tissue forms what? Corpus luteum. Corpus luteum starts secreting progesterone. Then endometrial gland secrete their secretion and under the effect of progesterone. Okay, if oocyte is not fertilized within 24 hours, then corpus luteum becomes inactive and it is converted into what? Corpus albicans. Then secretion of progesterone and estrogen completely stops. Then tissues of degenerating endometrium and unfertilized ovum is discarded. This is called as menstrual cycle. Okay, so this menstrual cycle, if you learn this 10 points and elaborate it, that is more than enough. Just you have to remember the 4 hormones involved in menstrual cycle. Hope you have understood this, children. Now let us just quick revise the modern technology, which just now I have done the video. We can just go through it. This all this we had done before unit test, so I was revising. So this we have learned. Many couples cannot have children due to various reasons. In case of women, it will be due to irregularity in menstrual cycle, difficulties in oocyte production, and obstacles in oviduct, difficulties in implantation in uterus, and many other reasons are responsible for this. Even in male, there will be absence of sperms in the semen, slow movement of sperms, abnormalities in the sperms are the reason in the case of males. But with the help of advanced medical technique like IVF, surrogacy, sperm bank, the childless couple can have child. So can we revise what is IVF? Okay. In vitro fertilization, that is in that the embryo is fertilized, everything in the outside the body, that is in the test tube, and after that it is implanted into the uterus. Okay.